Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Imams al-Bukhari and Muslim reported on the authority of Abdullah ibn Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhuma that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّمَا مَثَلُ صَاحِبِ الْقُرْآنِ كَمَثَلِ صَاحِبِ الْإِبِلِ الْمُعَلَّقَةِ إِنْ عَاهَدَ عَلَيْهَا أَمْسَكَهَا وَإِنْ أَطْلَقَهَا لَهَا. The similitude of the companion of the Qur'an, the one who has the Qur'an as his friend, always with it, always reciting it, always reviewing it, always memorizing it, is like that of the owner of a hobbled camel. If he is continuously cautious, he will retain it. But if he neglects it, it runs away. People with regards to the Qur'an are at different levels. Some people only listen to the Qur'an. Some people only recite the Qur'an. Some people partially memorize the Qur'an. And a less selected group memorized the entire Quran. And the scholars said that people's level and rank are proportional to the amount they memorize with the condition that they act upon it. And Allah Azza wa Jal created mankind, and He instilled in us to naturally forget things. And that's why when someone memorizes the Quran and does not repeat it, review it frequently, he will forget it. Likewise in anything else, in math, in engineering, in medicine, if the person does not refresh his memory frequently and continuously, the tendency is to forget. And the scholars said perhaps there is a wisdom behind this, behind us forgetting. And they mentioned among the things, one, that if we were to memorize and not to forget, then the hearts would not be distinguished. The one whose heart is attached to the Quran will not be distinguished from the one who's careless. How? When we forget, the one who's keen, the one who's careful, the one who has the Quran as his companion will continuously and frequently review and recite the Quran. Why? He doesn't want to forget it. Whereas the other type is different. He neglects it and stops reciting it or reviewing it until he forgets it. Another issue here is pertaining to the reward. Imagine if we memorize the Quran and have no worries about forgetting it. Then there will be no motivation for us to frequently recite the Quran and therefore lose out on an abundant amount of reward. As in the narration of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, reported by a Tirmidhi, classified as authentic by Al-Bukhari, the Prophet said, whoever recites a letter from the and it does not mean altogether is a letter, but rather alif is a letter, lam is a letter, and meem is a letter. And for information, there are about 325,000 letters in the Quran. You see the amount of reward one would be losing out on if he does not or she does not recite the Quran continuously. There is a shepherd from Sudan who memorizes the Quran. A man asks him, every how often do you finish the Quran? He said, every 2 days. He said, you need to tell me that you review 15 juzus of the Quran, half of the Quran daily? He said, yes. But sometimes I get lazy and I finish it every 3 days. That's one third of the Quran per day. That's one who is keen on maintaining and retaining his memorization of the Quran. Ibn Hajar, rahmatullahi alayhi, said, the reason the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used the camel in particular for the similitude here is that the camel is known to be the one animal that has the most tendency to run away. Now, once it runs away, it is the most difficult animal to retain and bring back. And he said, this is why. The Quran, once it leaves you, it takes a whole lot of effort to retain it again. So, just as a camel owner is keen on tying its knees, this is how they prevent the camel from running away. They tie its two knees together. Therefore, a person who memorizes the Quran or portions of the Quran should be as keen in his revision of the Quran. Ibn Hajar extracted some beautiful benefits and instructions from the Hadith. He said, we need to remember, as the Prophet said, that the Quran will escape. It will run away very easily and very rapidly. So we need to be careful. Number two, it encourages us to frequently review the Quran and recite the Quran in order to maintain it. Number three, he said, we need to know that lofty ranks are not easily obtained. They need effort to be exerted in order to achieve. Al-Qadiyah, may Allah have mercy on him, said, and this is something I say to my students all the time in the deep classes, the Quran classes, and those who are present will recollect now when I say what I'm going to say. Al-Qadiyah said that the more one recites the Quran, the easier it becomes on his tongue to utter it. It becomes easy for you to look at the book of Allah and go through it faster. And the less you recite, the more difficult it becomes for you to read. Just like the scholar of the Quran, one of the most eminent scholars in the sciences of Quran, Muhammad ibn Jazari al-Shafi'i, rahmatullahi alayhi, said, وَلَيْسَ بَيْنَهُ وَبَيْنَ فَقْهِهِ إِلَّا رِيَاضَةُ رِيْلٍ بِفَقْهِهِ. The protection for one to forget the Quran is, he literally said, exercising your jaw, meaning frequently repeating it and moving your mouth and jaw and tongue with it. The Qur'an is a blessing from Allah Azza wa Jalla. It's a light that illuminates our path towards guidance. It's the strong bond. The one who holds on to it has indeed grasped on the strongest, most trustworthy handhold that has no break in it, and whoever neglects it will certainly deviate far away. The Quran is the source of reformation of the Muslim Ummah, politically, financially, socially, and so on. It organizes the Muslim community's affairs and life. It rectifies the affairs of individuals and governs the conduct and behavior of the believer. It is the remedy for the illnesses of the heart. And it is the softener for hard hearts. As Allah has said, Allahu nazzal ahsan al-hadithi kitaban mutashabina. Allah has sent down the best statement, the best speech, a consistent book. مَثَانِيَ تَقْشَعِرُ مِنْهُ جُلُودُ الَّذِينَ يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ. Oft repeated, the skins of those who fear the Lord shiver from it. ثُمَّ تَلِينُ جُلُودُهُمْ وَقُلُوبُهُمْ. Then their skins and hearts relax and soften. Why? ثُمَّ تَلِينُ جُلُودُهُمْ وَقُلُوبُهُمْ لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. For the mention of Allah, for the Quran. Mathan, oft repeated. The scholar said, this means that the more it is repeated, the sweeter it becomes in the heart of the believer. And this is certainly is experienced, and I'm sure all of you have experienced this. The more you recite the book of Allah Azza wa Jalla, the more sweetness it has to it. It never seems to astonish you. And it also means that the instructions, the guidance, the lessons, the admonitions in the Quran are also repeated, so they become deeply instilled and firm in the hearts of the minds of the believer. Allah also gave the Quran an amazing name. Allah says, وَكَذَلِكَ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ رُوحًا مِّنْ أَمْرِنَا. And thus, we have revealed upon you a life-given inspiration of our command. It is the source of life for the heart. Meaning, without it, our hearts die. Without it, our hearts harden. Without it, we become like robots, not humans. So how can it be the source of our lives, the life for our hearts, and neglect it? How can it be the source of light and be abandoned? How can anyone desert it when it is so beneficial. Not only that, there's a certain warning for those who forget it. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, rahmatullahi alayhi, said, whoever forgets the Qur'an is sinful. Ibn Munabi, rahmatullahi alayhi, said, our Salaf continued to fear forgetting anything they memorized from the Qur'an because they thought that this, or they believed that this was a sign of decline for them in faith. And Imam al-Nawawi gave a stronger statement regarding forgetting the Qur'an. He said, Islam encouraged us to review and recite the Qur'an frequently, lest we forget it. Why? He said, forgetting the Qur'an is one of the major grave sins in Islam.
Not acting upon it.
among the consequences, the evil consequences of abandoning and deserting the Qur'an, is that the Prophet will complain against us to Allah has
be right.
don't act upon the Qur'an, we subject ourselves to be pierced by the Qur'an. Brothers and sisters, it is not befitting for Qur'an to be such an important thing in our lives, and we only give it what's left over from our times. Some people don't hold the Qur'an except in Ramadan. This is when they know that there is something called Qur'an. Some people are better. They remember it on Friday. Why? What's our problem with the Qur'an? How can someone supplicate Allah saying, Allahumma ja'al al-Qur'an rabi'a qalbi? Oh Allah, make the Qur'an the delight of my heart. How can it be the delight of my heart when I am deserted it all year long? When I don't touch it, except on Fridays. Or when I don't read it daily. And if I do read, I read 2-3 verses. Brothers, this is the source of life to my heart and yours. This is our protection from deviation. This is our prosperity. Don't we want that? Don't we strive to get that? Don't we always complain? My kids are giving problems. My husband is harsh. My wife is disobedient. My boss is too bossy. This is happening. I'm losing a lot of money. My car is always in accident. Of course, for an hour and literally. This is the consequence. It's a natural result. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to remove our hearts, to rectify our fears, to make our hearts attached to the Qur'an, to make us love reciting the Qur'an and memorizing the Qur'an, to find life, to find joy when we recite the Qur'an. Allahumma ighfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit aqdamana wansurna.